Hello!
Welcome.
This is Brother Andrew. When I first started watching the beer reviews, I saw the Master of Hoppets, Peter, reviewed one of these beers and review more from this brewery. Then I saw Tuvar, David, the Viking. But just before I saw Tuvar review this, I just purchased it on the Master of Hoppets recommendation. This is the Cantillon, and it's a Gueze 100% Lambic Bio, and it's 5%. The thing about this beer is, where has it gone? It's bottled March 2011. Right. It's almost a year plus since it's been bottled. It's 15th of April 2012. And you can drink it till... where's it now? I saw it on the thing. It does say it on somewhere. But
let me have a look.
Yeah, Andrew's going to open it up anyway. But Andrew just managed to purchase a bottle of this, similar to this, I think, the Doncaster Beer Festival. Got it open.
Is it there? It says 2030.
Ah, okay. Yeah, you can basically leave it till 2030. But do you want to open it? Maybe our little man from Belgium. Not from Belgium. Bulgaria.
Bulgaria. Yeah.
See what happens when you drink too much. You mix Belgian beers with Bulgaria.
I'm having trouble getting the lid off then.
Will it be the cork? I don't know if he's allergic to cork, but cork beer. But there's cap. Now, Andrew works in the trade, so he should be able to get this off pretty quickly. Now, we're on a time schedule, so... gotta pour it. Now, it does say on the cork, just to get it off the bottle opener. Don't pour it too aggressively. Wow, it's fragrant. There you go. Brussels.
I'm smelling the bottle.
I'm smelling the cork. It does smell like the beach.
You smell that?
Yeah, you smell that. It smells like the beach, doesn't it?
It has that sandy smell. You sort of like, do you get the peach?
I get the peach and some sort of, like, sea fish and stuff like that. You know what I mean? I mean, when we went to Belgium, we've been to Belgium, we've been to Germany, we've been to France, we've been to Italy, we've been to Spain. You know what it smells like? It smells like,
did it smell a bit orange?
A peach wine.
Yeah. You get a bit of citric smell.
Yeah.
Is that a bit of liminal? Or...
No, it just smells, it's peach. It's every scent of peach. Oh, I did purchase beer, I think, via Trembling Manus in York. But I'm getting lots of peach. But yeah, I mean, we've travelled to Germany, Belgium, and Spain, France, Italy, and Sardinia, and...
Oh, I'd like to travel to Ireland to get some of those Irish
porters. Yeah.
But
it's the
transportation of getting across the waters.
Yeah, I think our next goal is Ireland. I've done America. He's done the majority of the Europe.
Yeah, I mean, I went up to Scotland and got some beers from there.
Yeah, Scotland's amazing for beers.
But the Fern Brewery and there's several
but,
in there.
Yeah. But you're getting lemon, peach.
Very sour. You can get that sour.
I mean, when I went in America, we tried, me and Herbie, Jill, Susan, and we tried many sour beers.
I'm just seeing if I can get it back in there.
You emptied it?
Yeah, it's empty.
Oh, okay. This is 5%.
There we go. We'll put it in your cellar, you'll collectionize them.
I mean, I've tried many sour beers when we're in America.
It sort of brings you back to reality.
Yeah.
You know, when you're trying beers and you try to get that subtle taste and then it, ooh, like that.
I mean, we've tried, today we've tried beers from Yorkshire, UK, Europe, America. They've all been like from 7% to 9%.
We started off in Lancashire. Went to Manchester.
Yeah.
Then we went to the Leeds Brewery one.
Yeah.
Which was
because we went from Lancashire to went from Lancashire to America and then America to
That way, yeah. Yeah, the Cappuccino Stout.
Yeah. Mm. And we've tried so many brewers today. And we've been to Scotland as well in taste buds. But
that's a taste bud on that, you know what I mean?
I mean, they've all been high volume beers. But this one has just been 5%. And it's just impounded more so much into that little 5% more than the combined amount of what we drank today.
I mean, it might be because it's like a sour one. I don't know the reason why with the cork. It might be a particular reason for it.
I mean, look at the color on that. That's very rich in peach and light orangey tan color. Mm. And
a lot of Belgian beers, a lot of people mentioned about them, I don't know, the German beers, this is sort of about orange peel.
Yeah, they do, in the wheat beers, they do. It's standard.
Mm.
But for me, this has been the highlight of the day, basically, and it's only 5%. It's one of the reasons Germany and Belgium above all
the other beer areas.
They give you a beer at 5% and it has more flavour, taste and power than an American beer or a Scottish beer or a UK beer or a Yorkshire beer.
Mm.
At 9%. It just shows you how good Belgium are at making beers.
I mean, I had a summer wine and it had a Belgian style and it was absolutely formidable. But
there you go. Belgium's awesome at beers. Very good beer. Recommended. You take care. Goodbye.
Goodbye.